lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, and I'm going to show you a tour of my Airbnb here in Vienna. I am standing at the front door. To the right is the bedroom. Here is the foyer. To the left is the toilet room, the bathroom, then the living room, dining area, TV area, and the kitchen. Let's go here to the bedroom first. So it's actually my last day. I'm leaving tomorrow morning, so I'm actually all packed. What it looks like from the bedroom window. It's like a little courtyard area, which is pretty nice. And then more buildings. And you see a full-length mirror here. And it opens up. It's got some nice IKEA hangers there. A couple more drawers down here. I didn't use this. I hung up my clothes for a little bit. And then some more shelving here. This Airbnb is good for three people. Here is the bed, which was very comfortable because it has kind of like a memory foam here. The blankets were very comfortable. The pillows were very comfortable. It was a great, great bed. A lot of Airbnbs, they kind of have just the basic box spring mattress, and I'm used to sleeping on a memory foam, so this was really nice. And then the plugs for Europe are like this. Here's a little side desk. It's a drying rack. I love this, especially because we have a dachshund. That's Picasso. Okay, here's the toilet room. So here's what the light switches look like. There's a window that goes, I think everyone's window goes up there, so there's some air there. I think what's great about having a separate toilet room, especially if this is good for three people, you know, one can use that and one can use the bathroom, and there's a sink in the shower room also. This is a nice piece of furniture. I wonder if it's IKEA. So, some extra stuff there. Here's for shoes. I didn't really need to use that. Oh, they provide slippers. I didn't even open that up. You can put your purse here, some more shoes there, or two bags. And then it has this little rack, couple of hooks there. This is where I hook the keys. And then here's a little tray for your shoes so you don't track it in. So this shoehorn is there. Very simple, but very true. To travel is to live. There is a door to the living room, which is nice because the third person can sleep on that couch. I'm not sure if that pulls out. Here's the door to the shower room. So this just closes like that. I just have it open. Here's, I think this is a heating rack. I don't know how to operate it. Very basic, nice and clean. More storage down here. So he did provide a little bit of detergent. Here's the medicine cabinet with a mirror. Some more storage in there. There, also the window going up. Provides a dryer with hooks. Isn't that great? Here, I think this is the water heater. All the towels were on here. And this is nice because you have more plugs if you want to, if you need anything else electric, like a curling iron or a shaver, things like that. Here's a laundry machine, cabinet for storage. So this was very convenient because instead of putting my toiletries, toothbrush stuff, or dental stuff, makeup here on top, I just put it here in the cabinet. Okay, here's some more drawers. And then more cabinet and extra trash bags. This is a heater for the floors, and the tile heats up here and also in the kitchen. And here's the light switch for here. Over here by the front door, this is to call down or if somebody rings, you can talk to them. And another light switch here. And the flooring is the same here as in the bedroom. Little dinette for three, but his clock is not working. Probably just needs to add a battery. It's just nice sleek furniture, the same as in the bedroom. Nice little decor on the side. At first, I thought it was going to be rough, but it's very comfortable. So the first night, I needed a fan to sleep. Love the elephant. So these windows, you can turn it left, and it opens wide that way. You can turn it up, and it opens up that way, which is nice. To close it, you go all the way down. So let me show you the view. So this is definitely a neighborhood. That's what I love about Airbnb. Oh, it's supposed to, it might rain today. Okay, that's the neighborhood. Parking is on the street. I believe this is a one-way street. Cool, no? So cool. That's what I love about Airbnb is you get to live amongst the locals. Then from the living room, this is what the view looks like. Very nice and clean. Very minimalist type of approach to the decor. Here to the right is the fridge. Okay, there was some beer in there already. And some leftovers. Freezer drawers. Left ice cream. Drawer. Has a hot water kettle here, electric stove, and then actually an oven. There is no microwave to provide some espresso guidebooks and then trash bags. I really like this Airbnb, like as far as the things he provided. He doesn't provide toiletries, which is fine because you're usually prepared for that, but you don't bring cleaning supplies, right? He's got a paper towel there. Obviously people have left some of this, or he's got some containers there. Plates. Our Airbnb in Manila and Tokyo, I didn't video. So tired in that trip, but one thing I noticed, which I think is a great idea, especially if it's an apartment of that you have, is to provide cleaning supplies, because even if you're there like the third day or even the second day, you may want to clean out the sink or whatever you've been using. This is the, look, just pull it open. Flooring is the tile that heats up, so I do like how even the fridge and the hood are kind of hidden like that. A map of the local area, especially, you know, like the restaurants around the tram station and the 24-hour bakery. Thanks for taking this tour with me in my Airbnb here in Vienna, Austria. If you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm waiting long for you, so be my princess for life.